Hi, this video is going to be about wrestling routines. You know, I am a big wrestling fan and I come on YouTube a lot, and basically I know about these problems in TNA and making it an alternative, and then you'll bring a super, and then you'll say I was the purest wrestler in the world, so you should automatically champion. So these are a few topics I'd cover. What I'm gonna do is, first of all, how I would save, I would make TNA a better product. I would limit Hulk Hogan to set amount of days a year. Well, I would also, first of all, buy the Ring of Honor product and deploy it in America as a UK promotion, because it's the biggest market, like WWE Ring of Honor in India. Then, this Bound for Glory 6, I would have it effectively going all year, every belt. And what I mean by that is, so you basically get 10 points for submission win, 7 for pin win, 2 for count out, and minus 10 for the issue. The guys are using this Kurt Angle, for one night. I might say for one night is what I do. I leave Angle off TV. I'm having a feud with a Rampage Jackson, and I would just do vignettes, and I would have been clean and cut one more, never touch. Come to Bound for Glory, in better lockdown, because it's a cage, and it's MMA style. Then they have their match. Anyway, back to my idea for the Bound for Glory series, and I would have probably, I would have some more Joe. I would have Abyss, I would have Matt Morgan, I would have Doc. As I say, Cash Bradley, the gimmick that he didn't bring cooking, I would hire Knox. I would bring back Rhino and people like that, and Bobby Roode and Ken Anderson. And basically what do is, among this as well, I'd have some more Joe business, some more submission machine. And by the way, the leader at the end of this, at the end of one month, will get a title shot, and they won't do pay-per-view either. I do a special on Spike TV, but I do pay-per-view in the UK market. Be the all-out leader in Top Shape Role. There's a new feat. Then I take a guy like Bobby Roode, and I would have him be the smart guy. The guy that is getting whoops, the guy that is getting guys counted out, the guy that is getting guys disqualified. Again, like he did on Impact, I would have him be the guy that's taking points off people. And up the closer ones, about the first match between Joe and Elizabeth was vacated to the title. And it made it look like Joel's gonna win. And then in comes Matt Morgan, kicks Joel, beats him down. Actually, no. Not Morgan. Jeff Jarrett hits Joel with a guitar and says, "I am the founder of this company." And then, it's my company, and this is the guy I want to represent. So then you've got Manchester Joel Jarrett, which is a feud that's been dumbled in the last year. And you can have Joel on the political stuff, and you're a Ruby champion, you're over everyone. And then Joel comes back and eventually beats me in the X Division. I would use Jeff Hardy, Austin Aries, AJ Styles, Billy Williams, and then Dirk, Chris Daniels, Kaz, people like that. And I think this would create more purity in the title. So every match would be every match, and these guys are only three guys in that group. So the points would go on better. I think that would work better with the product. Now, I saw a TV being big in the UK. Now, British wrestling was big in it. Which is now, what I would like to see more from wrestling. I don't look this up. Do I know this? My uncle's dad was the wrestler Jane Eustace. Thank you, no. And in the 80s in England, he had a rival with Big Daddy. They used to fight once a year. And it just used to get them. Used to get 10 million viewers on ITV, which I don't know what translates into the States, but it's amazing. And your characters like Matt Ruckle, Faith Finley, Steve Regal, the Dynamite Kid, and Britain was always bigger than British Bulldog. British Bulldog, in my opinion, married his way into that, and that's where he got bigger. Anyway, I'm sorry joking now, but I like to use that philosophy. And I suggest for watching a match from the FWA in 2003. I think it's Eddie Guerrero versus Joe Gulliam. Joe Gulliam at the time was an anarchist. And he was just the biggest singer in the UK. And also these people like Nigel McGuinness. Hey, what do you think of my ideas? Comment if you like this video. Thank you.